Thank you for joining us. It has been a very busy August. You saw from our students how we started off the month, and you heard about our curriculum development. But we also welcomed our new staff and our second-year teachers at our orientations and held mentor meetings, all organized by Kent Bania and Janine Loconsolo, with the assistance of our leadership team. I would also like to recognize Lindsay Council, our HR administrative assistant, who we couldn't get through any of our hiring without. Thanks for staying tonight, too. The days were really wonderful days, featuring a bus tour hosted by our own athletic director, Joe Pyro. Discussions of the teacher evaluation framework, presentations on security, and presentations from our teachers association, as well as benefit information and a lunch sponsored by our insurance provider, IMEC. We were also able to welcome our students to the John Walker Middle School and our freshmen to the Nutley High School this week. And I have to tell you, I am so grateful for a faculty that's excited to have the students back in the buildings. It's really not the same place without the kids, and our enthusiasm, all of our enthusiasm for having them back is palpable. I will be welcoming the faculty and staff on Tuesday morning. And just a reminder, there is a half day for students next Wednesday and Thursday, and next Friday is the first full day for students. Now, much of my time this month has been spent monitoring enrollment and making some incredibly difficult decisions regarding variances and class size. As you've heard me say repeatedly over the last year, our elementary schools are at capacity and then some. We've had more than 130 requests for variances. That means requests for students to attend other than their home school. In addition to the variance requests, and I hope you are all sitting down and holding on to your seat for this, we've had an additional 146 new registrants to the district in K-12 between July 1st and today. I'm gonna tell you that we have more coming. I've continued to prioritize providing variances to those siblings of special education students, first of all. We talked about that last summer. For example, at Lincoln School, we had 34 variance requests. 20 of those were for siblings. And honestly, by calling several parents, convincing them to rescind their requests if they were only based on class size or things that we couldn't attend to, such as, you know, that's where I grew up, that's where I went to school. We were able to honor most of those requests. We also allowed 3 of the 7 families we displaced last year, meaning families that were not able to be in their home school at registration because there was no more room. We allowed them to stay at the schools where we registered them, again, not their home school. And by doing that, I was able to meet all of the requests for special education sibling placements. Additionally, I was able to grant requests to 3 staff members. Those staff members pay 50% tuition to have their children attend our schools as part of the collective bargaining agreement we have with the teachers. One of those requests was for a new kindergarten registration, and while the student will be joining us, not at the kindergarten requested. I was not able to honor staff members' request to enroll a child in pre-K. The family didn't participate in our lottery. We have a long waiting list, and it was not possible to create a spot for that child. Additionally, I was able to maintain our students whose families moved in 4th or 5th grade, so they were able to graduate with their class in 5th and 6th grade. And I will say with that, our biggest challenge is the siblings of those older students, right? They've been in the schools for a couple of years in our general education program, and sometimes we have a request for a kindergarten variance when the sibling's in 6th grade. That is a challenge. I was not able to grant most of those requests, but in the few instances I was able to grant a variance, I did reiterate that the requests are reviewed on a yearly basis, and there's a pretty good chance we're not going to be able to honor the variance requests next year. We did have to expand a section of kindergarten at Radcliffe School, and at this point, all families with requests have been notified. The parent portal for the middle school and high school is already open, and for our elementary students, that portal does open tomorrow afternoon, so you'll be able to know what homeroom your student's in and the name of their teacher. As you can probably imagine, this is challenging not only for the families, but for the principals and the teachers who remained in flux this close to the opening of the school year. And unfortunately, as I said, we're not done yet. We've already had to displace four families from their home schools, and we still have pre-registration appointments scheduled for an additional 48 students in grades K to 12. Seven of those are in pre-K, where there is a waiting list, 28 at the elementary school level, 6 at John Walker Middle School, and 7 at the high school. As of today, we have a number of sections closed in all 5 of our elementary schools. At Lincoln School, 3rd and 5th grade is closed, and 2nd grade only has 2 spots. And 1st and 4th grade only have 6 spots left at Lincoln School. At Radcliffe School, 1st, 5th, and 6th grade is closed. We did add a section of kindergarten. Spring Garden, 1st grade is closed. Washington School, grades 1 and 2 have 2 spots left. No, grade 1 has 2 spots left, grade 2 has 4 spots left. At Anacostia School, kindergarten is closed, and grade 2 has 1 spot left. Now, our guidelines for closing those sections are based on state guidelines for class size, kindergartens being at a 20, first and second grade being at 22, third grade at 23, fourth grade about 24, and fifth and sixth grade being at 25. I am going to tell you that first grade at Radcliffe and at other schools as well, but first grade at Radcliffe we're both at 23. My fifth grade at Radcliffe is at 26. I am out of space. I am going to just take a minute because I cannot recognize our registrars, Natty Ferreira and Jean Boyle, and our assistant, Mackie Mara, enough. They have spent countless hours tracking these kids in and out of schools, making sure they are at the right school. They have had tremendous patience navigating this process and helping our families who, as you can imagine, are frustrated that it's not as easy just to go to the school across the street. As I've been saying throughout the past year, we're at a critical point. As Mr. Carnesella just mentioned, we and the Nutley Board of Education are continuing the process of discussions with our bond counsel, architects, and attorneys regarding a future school board referendum. And as Mr. Carnesella said, our goal is that we announce and have our direction finalized by the next board meeting, September 11th, right here in this room. I encourage each of you, truly each and every one of you, to stay involved, stay engaged in the discussions, to continue to participate in the process. With your involvement, with your feedback, we can only continue to move forward with the momentum that the district's experienced and continue to help us enhance our students' experiences. On another note, as a fitting end to the summer and an honor to Labor Day, the district will close at 12:30 on Friday, get everything done that you need done before 12:30, and we will wish you all, faculty, staff, administrators, kids, parents, no cheering yet, parents, not until Wednesday, a relaxing and rejuvenating long weekend. We are looking forward to seeing the staff on Tuesday, all of our students on Wednesday, for the opening of another exemplary school year.
Thank you.